In today's video, I want to share an easy way to color grade your photos using a simple levels adjustment. And because you find the levels adjustment in many software packages, you can use this technique with any of them. Hello, I'm Robin Worley. Welcome to LensCraft. In this video, I'm using a levels adjustment layer in Affinity Photo, and I've already opened the image that I want to color grade. Let's add the levels adjustment by clicking the adjustments icon at the bottom of the layers studio panel. This displays a list of available adjustment layers, and I can select the levels option. You can see the new layers being added at the top of the layers studio panel and the levels dialogs open. When we color grade an image, we adjust the tones and colors in that image to create a style. The levels dialog gives us control over the image tones by adjusting the master channel. If we click on the dropdown, we can see there's also adjustments for separate red, green, and blue color channels of the image. This allows us to control the colors in the image as well. Let's start by editing the tones using the master channel and the levels sliders. When I move the black level to the right, you can see that it makes the image much darker. What's happening is that any pixels in the image that are darker than the slider value turn black. In this example, if I set the black level to a value of 50%, any pixels that are darker than the mid-tone grey will turn black. The other pixels that are lighter than the mid-tone grey are then redistributed across the histogram. You can see this in the Studio Histogram panel. Remember, the histogram shown in the Levels dialog reflects the layers below the Levels layer in the image. The histogram you see in the Histogram panel reflects all visible image layers, including our Levels adjustment. The white level works in the same way as the black level. When I set that to a 50% value, any pixel in the image lighter than a mid-tone grey becomes white. The remaining pixels in the image that are darker than a mid-tone grey are then redistributed across the histogram. If I use the gamma slider in the centre, we change the image brightness so that the overall image becomes either lighter or darker. Now watch what happens when I move the output black level to 50%. It makes the image appear faded, and the darkest tone in the image is now a mid-tone grey. You can see this reflected in the Histogram Studio panel, which shows there are no pixels on the left half of the histogram. The output white level does the same thing, but for brighter pixels. When I move that to 50%, it sets the brightest pixels in the image to be a mid-tone grey, which you also see reflected in the histogram panel. Now let's use this information to produce a matte, faded look for the image. All we need to do is move the output black level to 10% and the output white level to 90%. Then I'll increase the gamma slider to a value of around 1.2 to give the image a slightly darker appearance to counter the fading. When I turn the levels layer visibility off and on, you can see the effect it's having. Now let's look at how to adjust the colours in our image, starting with the red colour channel. This time when I move the black level to the right, setting the value to 50%, it removes red from the image. Then when I move the white level to 50%, it adds red to the image. The output levels do the opposite of these input levels. For example, whilst the black level removed red from the image, the output black level adds it. And whilst the white level added red, the output white level removes it. Now there is a subtle difference between how we add and remove colour from the image using the input and output levels. Notice the difference if I add red using the white level compared to the output black level. This is because the output black level is affecting the darker pixels in the image, increasing their red component. But the white level is affecting the lighter pixels in the image to increase the level of red in those. This gives you a lot of control over the pixels you're adding and removing red from. The other slider we should look at here though is the gamma slider. When I move the gamma slider to the right, it reduces a level of red in all the image pixels. But if I move it to the left, it increases a level of red in the same pixels. We can use this information now to produce a different atmosphere for our image by adjusting the colours. Start by moving the black level to around 10% to reduce the red in the darker pixels. This creates an interesting colour effect, but I can see a little bit too much red in the image still. I'll tweak that by moving the gamma slider to the right to a value of around 1.2. This further reduces a level of red, but this time from the entire image. Now I'll change to adjusting the green channel because it feels like there's a little bit too much green in the image. I'll reduce the level of green in the shadows now by 5%, allowing the shadows to shift towards a blue tint. For this image, I don't need to change the blue channel, but if I wanted to, I could use the controls in the same way. Instead, I'm going to go back to the master channel and move the output slider to 15%. The shadows feel a little like they're becoming blocked up, and moving it to 15% lightens them. If I turn the levels layer visibility off and on, you can see how the color grading has completely changed the atmosphere of the image. Something else you can do to further enhance this technique in Affinity Photo is to use the blending range controls. If you're not sure how to use them, watch this video next. You'll find that by combining the two techniques, you have complete control over the color grading effect. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.